I looked into your eyes.
What brings this woman in marriage to this man? Dearly beloved, we gather in the presence of God to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to witness the joining together of Dominique and Savanya, to surround them with our prayers and to ask God's blessing upon them so that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in their love for God. God created us male and female and gave us marriage so that husband and wife may help and comfort each other, living faithfully together in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, throughout all their days. God gave us marriage for the full expression of the love between a man and a woman. In marriage, a woman and a man belong to each other and with affection and tenderness, freely give themselves to each other. God gave us marriage for the well-being of human society, for the ordering of family life, and for the birth and nurture of children. God gave us marriage as a holy mystery in which a man and a woman are joined together and become one, just as Christ is one with the church. In marriage, husband and wife are called to a new way of life created, ordered, and blessed by God. This way of life must not be entered into carelessly, or from selfish motives, but responsibly and prayerfully. We rejoice that marriage is given by God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and sustained by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let marriage be held in honor by all. Let us pray together. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Dominique and Savanya, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them so that with steadfast love they may honor the promises they make this day. Through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Savanya and Dominique, having heard how God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, Savanya, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter into that covenant? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Having heard how God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter this covenant? If so, say, I do. And do all of you, the families and friends of Dominique and Savanya, give them your blessing? And do you promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage?
We do.
I like it. Enthusiasm. Thank you. They made promises and encourage and love you through this. And it is not easy, but it is good.
Yeah.
The scripture that you have chosen, well, Savanya chose, I hope you like it. We've had lovely conversations for the last 3 months and prayed a lot for you. From 1 Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these love. Let us pray. Lord, speak to us from your word that we may know what true love really is, and that we may truly live in love. Amen.
Amen.
Without love, Paul says to the church in Corinth, it's all empty and it's all meaningless. This passage is not only about romantic love, although that is beautiful and meaningful. It's about God, that God is love. You need each other, and you need God to hold it all together. You need everyone here. Look at all these people and many more. You need them to help you in this marriage. All of you were invited here today to celebrate and witness this wedding, and you're also here to help them, to help Dominique, to help Savonia, to uphold the vows that they take today. They need you. You both come here today full of excitement and enthusiasm and lots of anticipation. She just said, I wonder what he looks like. I said, well, he's skinny. But I'm sure there's a lot of muscles under there.
Yes, ma'am.
But I wasn't going to look. You can do that later.
Okay.
You can have a full of joy.
Wait, what? Now.
And there's lots of hope and excitement and joy. And this is a day we truly celebrate.
Yes.
Hold on to those feelings. Life can be full of joy, and it can be full of hope if it remains in our hearts. But every day of your life is not your wedding day. And when things get hard, and I promise you it will, there will be a day when you wake up and you look at that man and he's not so skinny and muscly. And you think, this is not the same guy that I married. And you're still going to choose to love him. And you're going to look at this woman and you're going to say, this is not that girl that I saw that first day of college and thought, oh, I got to meet her.
Yeah.
But you're still going to choose to love her. And there will be hard days, whether it's your choices or the choices of other people or just the circumstances of life. But get in the way and make life hard. You need to hang on to each other instead of pushing each other away. You need to hang on to love. Remember the words of God. These words are given to you today to write them on your hearts. Love is patient and love is kind. Be patient and kind with each other. You hold each other's hands today, but they're only a symbol of how you hold each other's hearts. You have a great power to love and cherish one another or to destroy that heart. I challenge you to cherish and to love. Protect that precious heart. Remember that love always protects and always trusts. Without trust, you don't have a marriage. Be trustworthy and live in trust. Love always hopes. I want you to hope great things for each other. Only God knows the amazing things you're going to do with your lives. But you can hope and dream and share those together. Be full of adventure. Wherever it is that the Marine Corps sends you and wherever it is that God sends you, all of it can be an adventure.
Yes.
Excited for sharing that together. Celebrate with and for each other the great achievements and the small ones. And notice each other. Love doesn't ever, ever give up. In my conversations with Savanya, I said, what are you looking for? And what do you want this man to be in your life? She said, I want honesty. I want him to follow through with his commitment. There's a lot of commitments today that are going to take a lifetime to follow through on. I want him to listen to me and feel like I've been heard. And to be there for me. To spend time with and for each other. That can be the greatest gift you give. love doesn't give up. God will never give up on you. Don't give up on each other. Pray with me. God, we thank you for these, your words to us. We thank you for the promise that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I pray right now that you would strengthen Savannah, that you would strengthen Dominique, that they would know that you can do anything for them, and they can do anything when you're with them. Lord, I pray that you would help them to love each other every day of their lives, to live in love, to act in love, to be patient and kind, and not keep a record of how many times you left your dirty socks on the floor, but to love and cherish and care for each other. Lord, help them to celebrate, to help them to be the husband, to be the wife that you created them to be in this relationship. And may they know that it's only through you that holds them together. It's in the powerful name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You need to pass off your flowers and hold his hand.
Jesus, hallelujah.
Dominique and Savannah, it is your intention to marry, join hands, and with your promises bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife.
Jesus.
Dominique, repeat after me. I, Dominique, take you, Savannah, to be my wife. And I promise, before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful husband. In plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Savannah, repeat after me. I, Savannah, take you, Dominique.
I, Savannah, take you, Dominique.
To be my husband.
My husband.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
What do you bring as a sign of your promises? Beginning and no end, we are reminded that you are eternal. That before the world began, you were there, and until the world passes away, you will be there. Lord, would your eternal love, your eternal presence bless this man and this woman. May they always be reminded that you are with them, that it is your strength that helps them to be faithful to these vows. That is your commitment through them, that they will love and cherish one another. May these rings be a constant reminder of your love and their love for each other. It's in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Repeat after me. Dominique, I give you this ring. Being Dominique, they become man and wife, they get to be more. That there is more life, that there is more brightness in the world. Because we can do more together than we would ever accomplish. Dominique and Savanya, from this day forward, your thoughts shall be for each other rather than for yourself. Your plans will be mutual and your joys and sorrows will be shared alike. Now you will take these candles when I turn on to you and light the center candle, this Christ candle that reminds you that Christ is there to uphold you and strengthen you. As the radiance says, this one light cannot be divided. Neither shall your lives be divided, but will continue to be blessed in a home and marriage where God dwells.
Come on. Come on, girl. Oh, now you do it.
I didn't know you. All right, girl.